But you know, my friend, this whole world hates us. This whole world don't want nothing to do with us. It don't matter what we do for the Lord Jesus Christ. It says right here in John chapter 15 and verse 18, it says, if the world hated you, you know that it hated me before it hated you. Yeah. If you were of the world would love his own. But because you are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world. See right there. When we came, we gave our heart and life. We walked that aisle and we gave our heart and life to the Lord Jesus Christ. What did he say he done? He said, I have chosen you out of the world. That means when Jesus Christ came, he knocked on that old harsh door right here, this old harsh door right here, my friend. What? And you open that heart and you open your harsh door and you walk down that aisle and you got on your knee and you let Jesus Christ come into your life. He brought you out of this old world, my friend. You're no longer in this old world anymore, my friend. You don't have to live for this old world anymore. You know, God gives us an opportunity up on this old earth. Yeah. I believe God put us on this earth to make a choice, my friend.
Yeah.
To serve him or to serve the old devil. He said, we can see. We can't serve two masters. We got to serve one master. You got to love one and hate the other. You can't love both of them. If you love the devil, if you love the devil and love Jesus, it ain't going to work like that. You got to love God or you love the old devil, this old world. And you know, my friend, I'm going to tell you something about this old world. This old world ain't going to take you to heaven. This old world can't do that and pray. All the things this old world or here does bring you down. They send you straight to hell, my friend. This whole world will. This whole world don't care nothing about you. He don't care what you got. He don't care what you do. He don't care nothing about you.
Yeah.
The only thing it cares about is how much you can give to the old devil. What you can do for the devil here. What you can do for the devil there. That's what this whole world, that's all the old devil cares about. But you know, as soon as you come in contact that man called Jesus,
yeah,
and you get that blood that trickled down that old rugged cross, my friend, into your life, you've got that new body, my friend, that one day you're going to go home and live with the Lord Jesus Christ forever and ever and ever and ever. But you know, I'm going to tell you here tonight, if you ain't got that blood applied to your heart when you stand in front of God, he ain't going to say, go back down there, give your heart life made, then come back, and then you can go to heaven. It ain't going to work like that. You might play around with God down here. You might make people think you're a Christian. You might make people think you're a lot of things down here in this whole earth. But as soon as it comes your time to leave this whole world and you left this whole world, you stand in front of God, God ain't going to play with you, my friend. And it ain't going to be like you can play around with us down here. It's going to be either you're saved or you're lost. That's all it's going to be. There ain't going to be no difference in it when you stand in front of Jesus Christ. When it comes to our time to leave this old world, you say, Jesus Christ ain't coming back. I'm 60 or 70 years old. He ain't come back yet. But mark my word, my friend, the Bible says that Jesus Christ is coming back one of these days. Said he went away to prepare a place for us. And he's going to come back and get his own. Who's he coming back for, my friend? He's coming back for his blood bought. The ones that got that blood applied to their heart. That's the one Jesus Christ is coming back for, my friend, upon this old world. He ain't coming back for somebody just pretending like they got saved, pretending like they know Jesus Christ. Go to church today and wait 6 months and go to church again. That ain't the one Jesus Christ is coming back for, my friend. He's coming back for the ones that truly, truly loved him, truly, truly went to church, truly, truly tried to do what God would have me do right here in this old world. That's the ones God's coming back for. And when you stand in front of him, my friend, that blood better be applied to your heart. I'm telling you here tonight, my friend, that blood better be applied. Better not play around with Jesus. If you're even on your deathbed, my friend, I believe you better not give up on Jesus then, my friend, because it's going to be too late when you stand in front of him. There ain't going to be no hope for you then. You know, you better walk down that old path. I've heard Brother A.Y. many times. Go that old path. What's the old path? Right here is the old path. By this word right here. You go by this word right here, my friend, you go by the word of God, you'll never go wrong in this world.
Amen.
If you do what God would have you, if you do what this word right here tells you to do, if you live by God's commandments, you live the way that God would have you live, my friend, you ain't got nothing to worry about on this old earth. And when you stand in front of Jesus Christ, and he sees that blood applied, you ain't got nothing to worry about.
Right.
Look at the old rich man in the Bible.
Yeah.
He didn't do what God would have him do. He didn't do nothing God had him do. What happened to him? He died and he went to hell.
Yeah.
What happened to the old beggar, my friend, that was right there with him? Abraham carried him up in his bosom, took him to heaven. He was sitting over, he's in heaven. I bet the old rich man said, I wish I'd give that poor man anything he wanted. Wish I'd done everything I could for him. Now it's too late, see. It's too late to give his heart to God now. Because he's right there now. Lord, just take one drop of water, tip it on my tongue. That's all it takes, just one drop of water. But you know, that one drop of water never did come. But if you're out there tonight, my friend, you don't know Jesus Christ, call in let us know if you gave your heart and life to him. If you didn't rededicate your life to him, you know God's just standing there at the open arms, my friend, waiting for you to come back to him. Just like that old prodigal son in the Bible. Yeah. What did his father do for him when he seen him coming afar off? When he saw him coming there afar off, he outstretched his arms and said, come on home, son. Come on home, son. Yeah. That's just the same way Jesus Christ is with us today. Yeah. He's waiting right there with outstretched arms. If you need to rededicate your life, bow down on your knees right there in your living room, my friend, and say, Lord, come back into my life. Let me live the way that I used to live for you, Lord. You know, God will welcome you back in. He'll say, come on home, son. Come on home. It's time to come on home. You know, but we'll get the singers back up here. Let them get a song. We'll get the prayer request. But you know, if you're out there tonight and you don't know God, tonight's the night you can get to know God in 2013.
Amen. That's right.
It's a new year that you can get to know Jesus Christ tonight.
The new year, praise God. And we got some prayer requests right here. Fine preaching. Pray for Daisy Patterson family.
Amen.
Pray for Raymond England. Pray for Nora Lee Baker. Pray for Arliss Castle's family. He passed away. Oh, and they're hurting tonight. Pray for Beulah Gambrill. She's in the hospital. Pray for William, Brother William called in.
Jordan Warren family.
Jordan Warren family needs prayer tonight. Let's touch and agree. Oh, Father
Almost
God, Lord, we're so
Father,
thankful,
Lord, we come
Lord,
here tonight,
in Jesus'
Lord. Thank
name,
you, Lord, for another day, Lord.
What you can do, Lord, you've got all power in both heaven and in earth. You are King of kings and Lord of lords. You're the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Oh, praise God. At the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Amen. Glory. Listen.